It's time to shake this shit up.
Shake it up and shake it up.
Shake this shit
up and shake it up and shake it up.
Shake this shit up.
Shake it up and shake it up.
Shake this shit
up and shake it up and shake it up.
Shake this shit up.
Shake it up.
It's your girl Tamika.
It's your girl Kandice.
And we have a special guest.
Special guest.
Yay.
What's your name?
This is Amira. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Hookahs and Conversations. Let's get this shit popping. Shake it up, shake it up, shake it up. Okay, so we are here with Miss Amira. Let's take the miss out and just say Amira. The hookah is called Amira. Yes, okay? So this segment is all about Amira. Okay? So we brought her in today because we definitely want to talk about insecurities. Like, we all have them, you know?
We do. Everybody.
Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure everybody have them. And some people don't like to talk about theirs, but we're going to get it popping today. We're going to talk about all of ours. And we're going to start with... What is your insecurities?
My forehead. I got a big forehead.
Do you want to let people see?
Oh my god.
Like five fingers. I was just laying.
No, for real.
It's not. It's not. Let me see how big for fifth. Where's mine? Like a four?
Yeah, you like a four.
No, that's
four.
I'm like a
little five. It's like a four.
No,
like,
no, it's a four.
It's a four. It's a four.
It's a four.
Four.
Okay. It's a four.
You want, I don't you know. Want, look, you want, mine might be a five or a six. I don't know. Where am I?
Put the thumb up there. You definitely a five and a half.
Oh, I'm a five and a half. That's my insecurity, obviously. Let me pull my hat back down.
So, in school, right? Or whenever?
Just growing up.
Growing up, period.
Right. So, how did that become an insecurity for you, Kandice?
It's because my forehead was big. And every time I got a hairstyle, I always had to have a bang. When I was like a little kid, I always had a cut. It was straight across, bang. And then as I got older... And I started doing my own hair and getting weaves, I would have like a real big bang or a deep swoop. Like it'll be so, it like, you know how Leah used to do her swoops? That's my swoops would be so deep. So you couldn't see.
You want some of
the My no, forehead.
I'm just going to drink the drink.
You don't want to try it for the people?
Wine? I don't even know what kind of wine it is. I don't know nothing.
Okay, so I brought this wine here because actually, like, my husband, biker brother, always give me this wine. He said he only can find it at Publix. So it's a white wine. Y'all tell me what it tastes like.
It's sweet, but it's not sweet.
So
it's not sweet.
So
it's like a combination of sweet and dry. It's good.
It's good though, like Chardonnay mixed with, what you think, Moscato or something. I say it tastes like muscadines. Yeah,
you know what it does? Muscadines? It does. Mm-hmm. I was thinking apple, but now that you say that, it really does taste exactly like that. We need to look at the ingredients.
Let's see.
Where is this fly coming from? You have a fly.
I know,
but
that's what happened when the wine come out. The ingredients. That's a warning.
Delicious
in the bottle. I like that. Okay.
That's what we're
saying. So the hookah flavor we have, you guys, I went out and purchased more stuff.
Mighty Freeze, of course.
No, they didn't have that.
Really?
So we're doing blueberry with mint, and we're also doing this new flavor called strawberry orange orgasm.
Have difficulty saying that.
The orgasm?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh, she had trouble with that.
I did have trouble with that because maybe I need one.
Oh my God, Tamika.
Here we go.
When was the last time? God, you gotta think about it.
Every episode.
Cause you, I don't understand.
Bro,
we
I'm
whole
tired.
Okay, me too.
I'm like.
And we supposed to have, so on one of our episodes, we supposed to have like a challenge, right? I supposed to did it like 5 days in that week.
Okay.
Definitely didn't make it to the five. I think I only made it to like two or three. But this week, no, because I've been in pain.
Fun.
Yeah, I've been in pain. And bad, nothing up.
So it's so funny. Like, me and my husband did this one thing. I don't know where it came from. This was like some years ago. And, you know, he's a man. He mm-hmm. likes to, you know, mm-hmm. even as we get older, he right. still likes, yeah, you know, so very frequently. Uh-huh. But we were like trying to see if we could do it like every single day.
like
30 days. We were going to do a 30 day.
How many days did you make it?
I don't remember because this was a while ago, but we made it probably at least a good 20. He was like, I can't
do it anymore. They get tired too.
That's a lot.
That's a whole lot. It's messing with my brain.
Yes. Like,
it's too much. I was like, what? I never thought, like, ever. When have you ever heard a man say it's like too
it's
much?
Too much. Some men want it every day, though. Yes.
And he was like, hey, don't wake me up tonight.
Don't touch me.
He was like, don't wake me up tonight. He was like, I can't. I was like,
we're
going to call it a wrap for real.
It's a wrap.
So funny.
Like a video. It's a wrap. No, I don't want to see you at all for like 30 more days. Okay, yeah. So that's our topic, insecurities, because we had jumped straight into the topic.
I'm so excited.
I know. Excited to have Amira here with us. I'm so excited the whole day. So, okay, so let's talk about your insecurities. Like, what was your insecurity? You said forehead, right?
Mine was my forehead as well. It was a huge, and then my gap. I have, like, a gap. It's not as big as it used to be because I have braces. Mm-hmm. And then my dog ate my retainer, and my gap opened back up.
You never went and got another retainer?
No, because when I got my braces, I lived in Minnesota, and then I moved out of town to Colorado. And so in order to get another retainer, it was like way too expensive because I would have had to go to a whole new orthodontist. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, okay, I'll just go back to Minnesota and get one. And they were talking about like a flight to Minnesota. And then
I would have traveled for that.
Yeah, and so I was like, no.
I would have got a gap too.
I got a gap too.
My gap was like,
it was like a fearful.
Big. Yeah, I could put like a quarter in there. Ooh. And still have space. Yes. And so that's like our family. That's like our family trait. Like, my son has one, my daughter has one, my mom had one, my brother has one.
DNA.
Yes, we got strong DNA for real. Yeah. So that was like a huge insecurity for me. And then the forehead too. The forehead was big.
So are you over that insecurity as far as saying, I mean, you got closed up with your forehead?
I think I kinda am. I still have issues because I feel like as I'm getting older, I feel like it's getting bigger.
The cow is licking.
I know. You know, I have my moments. There's days where I'm like, "Ooh, I look cute today," and then it's like, "Ooh, the forehead is looking real, real big. I gotta, you know." And y'all know I have my little ponytail,
right,
and
so,
I
don't
like my little curly ponytail.
But you got nice hair, so it's like I'm not really paying attention to your forehead.
Right.
Well, I did. I don't remember what I was reading. Somebody said only pretty girls have big foreheads. So I was like, okay, I'm going to embrace that.
We all pretty girls.
Yes, we all pretty girls.
So as a child, how did that affect you?
I had very low self-esteem because I was very petite, but I had a big butt.
Okay.
I was super, super petite.
Please.
And I tell people all the time, you got to be mindful of things that we say to our kids because we don't realize when we're saying those things. Sometimes we say it like out of love and just kind of joking, but we don't realize how they internalize that. And I was super skinny except for my butt, so they used to call me skinny mini. They used to call me olive oil. They used to call
olive
me
oil.
Yes.
Yeah.
Remember olive oil from
Popeye? His girlfriend.
Okay.
Don't say names. Yes. So those are the names that they used to call me. And then, you know, you're getting it from your family who's supposed to love you. Mm-hmm. And
we do it the most, the family.
Yeah. And so, well, no, because I had my peers doing it too, like when I was in school. And it just made me feel very ashamed, and I was not able to accept who I was. And when I look back on pictures of myself, mm-hmm. at pictures of myself, I was like, oh my God, I was so cute. I was such a cute little girl. I can't believe I was ever like as insecure as I was, but I internalized that stuff. Mm-hmm. And it affected me, you know, mm-hmm. when I was growing up, it affected the choices that I made. I remember mm-hmm. being like devastated because there was this little boy I had a crush on. He was like, oh, I don't like skinny girls. And I was like,
oh, you like thick.
I know. I was like, well, I don't feel like I'm skinny like that because I had, you know.
Yeah, but
yeah. And so he was like, well, I don't like skinny. And I was like, it broke my heart. I was like, so sad. And so just, you know, dealing with that kind of stuff as you're growing up. And like I said, it affected, like, you know, choices that I made as far as people that I dated and seeking attention and, you know, seeking attention from the wrong people because they're like, oh, you know, they're not even looking at my face. They're looking at, you know, everything from behind. And it's like, oh, you're so pretty. How do you know I'm pretty?
You didn't even look
right. Right. But it's like, you welcome that because you just want those compliments.
You just want the pretty.
Yeah. And so, it just, you know, it wasn't.
Like, call me small, thick. Don't call me small. You know, don't call me skinny.
I mean,
it don't bother me now, but I was like, skinny.
Yeah.
You know, so before I get on my insecurities, how did you get over it? Or are you over it?
I think I'm over it. I don't care. I have my husband. My husband loves me. Every bit of me.
Period.
Don't care. Yes. Right. And so I think I just, as I've gotten older, just kind of learned to embrace who I am.
Mm-hmm.
And just kind of with doing inner work. And kind of self-talk and, you know, I'm a big proponent of, you know, journaling and just kind of dealing with our emotions and therapy and things like that. And so just, I never went and got therapy from a therapist, but just, you know, reading and studying and self-help books and, you know, that kind of stuff. I think that helped me.
You doing that as a teenager or as an adult?
As an adult. Because I went into social services when I got out of high school.
Oh,
so just kind of being in that field. And yeah, it was. I loved it. Very emotional, though. But just going to, you know, symposiums and, you know, different things. And just what you learn from other people and therapists and social workers. And then just doing my own inner work and just, you know.
So how did you cover, I didn't mean to cut you off, but how did you cover your forehead?
Oh, like same thing like Kandice.
Okay,
I did swoop. Like the swoop.
Okay.
I did the bang.
Okay.
The hat. And I had my hair short. People that have been watching your podcast, they know that your hair is short. You have a hat on today, but I've had my hair as short as your hair was. And I was like, oh, I'm cute. And so I think because I got so many compliments in that when I did it the first time, I was probably like in my 30s. And it's like I got so many compliments. With my short hair. It's like I love my short hair, and that kind of, I think, helped me to embrace, because I had it short for years. I think that helped me to kind of embrace the forehead. Yeah.
Because my little niece, like, she suffered with her insecurity, and she's only, how old is Kiana? She's only, like, between the age of, I got too many nieces and nephews. I'm going to say between the age of 10 to 13.
Yeah, that starts when we're young, because I was really
young. She wore her headbands, like, on her forehead.
Yeah.
You know, she don't know the soup thing yet, so I got to teach her that. But she don't, she has,
I got to come see her, be like, girl, let me tell you about the bangs and the soup.
She don't know that
well,
yet.
Well, no, it's like we shouldn't even tell her about the bang and the swoop. Let her know
and
that she's
it.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
And yeah, because it's like we, like I said, we say things to kids and our children and to each other. And a lot of times we say things out of love and just kind of in a joking way.
Right.
Like my son, I was telling, I think I told you, I call him Chubby Baby, even though he's 17 years old and he's a grown man.
Mm-hmm.
But he's starting to get a little belly and I call him Chubby Baby. And then it's like one day he's like out in my husband, his office is in the basement. He's got workout equipment down there. And he's down there working out.
Out.
I was like, hey, is he doing that? Because I called him Chubby Baby. And now he's feeling.
I mean, it hit the house.
Right, it did. And so it's like we don't really think about that. And so we have to uplift our kids.
Yeah.
And not even our kids, but just each other.
Each other, right.
And as Black women. Because we're so quick to just the jealousy and negativity and you know, trying to
a lot of that.
compete.
Yes.
And I'm super competitive, but you know, not compete in a hateful way.
Right.
And so we just have to do better.
I was talking to this one guy and he was like, you know, if not like even the Black culture, like the Black culture, Black women, Black men, if we spent more time as in embracing each other, then it wouldn't be that much hatred. You know, it wouldn't be all of, oh, I need to get what you got. It's like, I'm going to celebrate you while you have it, because maybe that's something that I want in you, but I'm going to make sure, like, ask you questions so I can get there.
Yeah.
Instead of saying,
and I'm going
to... I'm gonna get what you got. I'm gonna take it from you.
Right.
That's not.
And I'm gonna be excited when I see your accomplishments.
Right.
That's how I am. It's like when I see people doing things, it makes me excited. It's like, you know, I grew up in Minnesota and I grew up in Colorado, and we didn't see a lot of people of color.
Mm-hmm.
At least I didn't. In the field that I was in, it's like, you know, it was always Caucasian people. And so when I came to Georgia, it's like I see people in upper management,
mm-hmm.
In executive positions.
Mm-hmm.
being in position of power mm-hmm. and being able to kind of affect change and do things, it's like, why would you not celebrate that? It's like, why would you hate on somebody else?
But that's everywhere.
That's crazy to
it's
me.
It's everywhere.
That's crazy.
Because let me tell you something. When people, like, it's on the same subject. When people make rules and regulations, some people don't want to follow those things. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, if it's coming from you, because you're in management position, if it's coming from you, it's like, okay, I can hear you. But if it's coming from me, like if me and Kenneth was in the same position as we are, and then I became over her, you know, for example, not saying that that's how you are, but we're friends, and then I became over you, it's hard for you to listen to me,
right?
Because I'm in a management position.
She still sees you as a peer, and those right. lines are blurred a little bit,
right? Yeah. And then it's like, well, you didn't want the management position, you know, so you should apply for it if that's what you wanted.
Right.
But now that I got it, it's like, instead of celebrating and saying, I'm so glad you're moving into this and moving into that, I would say, hey, go to somebody over you, higher power, and say, hey, I don't think this person should be in that position because, you know, they my peer. That's hatred.
It is. It should be, hey, you know, this is what I've accomplished. Now let me see what I can do to bring you up here as
right.
well. And
right.
we're going to do this together.
Together.
And then
right.
we're going to bring, I had somebody, you know, a long time ago say that you put people in the position to replace you. It's like when you get ready to move on and do something bigger, you kind of bring somebody along with you so that when you leave that position, it's like they're going to take over for you, and then you guys just continue to grow. And
but it's hard. It's hard for
it
some people to see that. You know,
yeah.
let me train somebody to take my position,
mm-hmm.
and all they hear is my position.
Right.
They taking my position, so
right.
they only hear that one word, taking. You know what I'm saying? So they don't know how to celebrate that.
Yeah.
You know, so it's kind of difficult. But one of my insecurities was my teeth,
mm-hmm.
and I used to get, like, so, it was like my teeth and my skin, like the color I am.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, that was one of my episodes, light skin versus dark
mm-hmm.
skin.
Right.
And it's like, oh my God, I just wanted to do the Michael Jackson and just bleach my skin because I wanted to fit in, I
right.
guess.
It's
right.
so funny.
And that's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And with my teeth, I mean, they used to call me Choo Choo Train, rat mouth,
oh
and all
gosh.
Of that, but I started just smiling even more. That's why I can't stop smiling, you know.
Right.
I started smiling even more. So when I got older, I used to always be upset with my mom. Like, why you didn't take me to the dentist? You know, she took me, but she didn't go as far as in getting braces.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, why you didn't get my braces? Like, well, I got to pay for all this stuff when I get older. But now, when I did it now, it wasn't so much. It wasn't even on the fact that I'm doing this for other people.
Right.
This happened every time I started drinking. I'm doing this because I want to do it for myself.
Right.
Because I want my smile to look nice for me.
You
know what I'm saying?
You
so,
want to be happy.
Yeah.
yeah.
So I was just like, when I was younger, it used to tear me down.
Mm.
Like, I was like crying.
Right.
Had my sister fighting people.
Right.
Like, my two older sisters, I say, they was joning on me. Who they at? Where they at? Who are they? It could be my friend. She gonna beat them up.
Mm-hmm.
You talking about me. You talking
right.
about something that make me feel like I want to go out there and hurt myself.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Or hurt someone else because you're talking about me.
Right.
And those little things, you don't know how it affecting somebody because that little thing can make somebody want to take themselves away from this earth.
Can,
you know,
yeah.
those little things.
Yeah.
And then having your family, like you were saying earlier, having your family say certain things about you.
Right.
And that insecurity, like, I try my best not to say, with my little niece who got an insecurity about her head, I try my best not to say, get your big head,
yeah.
I try not to say little stuff like that, or,
yeah.
you know, your teeth or whatever. I try my best because I know how it was when I was a child.
Right.
So I would never try to bring up somebody's insecurities
right.
on them, you know what I'm saying, in a joking way, because
right.
it can be hurtful. You don't know what somebody would do.
Right.
I can say, your big forehead, and then you can go jump off a mountain. I don't know.
right.
So I try my best not to take it there.
Right.
You know, is there anything that y'all want to tell our listeners, like, how
wait,
they
wait, I forgot I had another insecurity.
What's that other insecurity?
My eczema.
Oh.
Yeah.
My eczema was really, really bad. It was on my face, my neck, my hands, my legs. And I would, in the summertime, I would only wear jeans. I would never wear shorts because it was on my legs real bad. And it looked real scary.
And you look nice with shorts.
I know, right?
Thanks. Okay, y'all. But I just started wearing shorts when I moved down here. So, like, 9 years ago. I just started wearing shorts. Because
wow.
it was so hot.
Wow. Is it because nobody didn't know you? It's like, I'm starting to lose
No, because that's how I was. Well, because it was hot. And I was like, I can't keep wearing jeans. It's like 1,000 degrees. Oh my
God. Yeah. You wore jeans all the way up to what age?
9 years ago.
What age was that?
So, like, what, 25? Dang. 26?
And that insecurity stayed with you for a long time.
Yes. Yeah, because my eczema was really bad. Like, my grandmother, she was a pastor, so she would pray over me to, you know, for God to take my eczema away. When I was a kid, they have pictures of me where I have socks that come up to here because I was scratched until I started bleeding.
Yeah. Ooh,
so now that I'm, you know, I'm older and medicine changed, technology changed, science changed. I'm on Dupixent. So now my skin is fine. I'm not itching. I'm not scratching. So
you're a bad one.
Nasty, okay? I don't care about my forehead and my skin. And I always have shorts on.
You definitely always have shorts on. Like, you show your stomach a whole lot.
Because when I started working at the post office, I had like the sweatpants in the summer. And somebody's like, why do you always wear sweatpants? Because you let... He was like, because your legs are not shaved. I said, no, I have eczema. He was like, what? It was Josh at work.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah, when I first started. But then I was like, it's hot in this damn truck. Like, I can't.
Right.
But then my skin started getting better, so now I was like, okay.
You're a hot girl summer. When I am and fall.
But my forehead, that didn't really, it bothered me as an adult, but I was married, so I'm like, I already got somebody, so I don't care.
Yeah. So, like, if y'all had to tell the listeners so we can get on and shake this shit up, what would y'all tell people to how to overcome those things? Or, I mean, I know we married, so we don't look at them as much now.
Right.
You know, I would say just married.
Don't worry about what people say.
Right. I mean, we all have flaws. Nobody's perfect. There is something about each and every one of us. It doesn't matter how beautiful you are. Mm-hmm. The Halle Berrys of the world. It's like they all have flaws and they have insecurities just like the rest of us.
That's
and
true.
You just have to learn to embrace them.
Right. So embrace it, right?
Right.
So it's about that time where we know. Do y'all want to shake it up or do you want to go ahead and play the segment game?
It's
a segment game that we ask. I'll call it
get to know. Okay, we can call it get to know.
So we have, okay, you guys, so we are about to play get to know. So, would you rather, I'm going to read the first question, and then I'll pass my phone down. Would you rather have the ability to see 10 minutes into the future or 150 years into the future? So you're going to see it for either 10 minutes or 150 years.
I don't want to see 150
right,
years.
That's
making
me real
dead.
Old.
Right. Oh, we're going to be dead.
Right. Give me 10 minutes.
I'm going to be like,
Amira was my ancestor. No, I'm going to say 10 minutes because we all do things and it's like, dang, I wish I could take that back. I want to delete.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm going to say 10 minutes.
And new Apple.
I know I want that.
I haven't did it yet.
Really?
Yeah.
I did.
I can't wait to do it. I'm going to tell you, I'm like, I did it. Okay, so here you go. Choose a question.
A question.
Let's see. Choose a good one, too.
Would you rather be forced to sing along or dance to every single song you hear?
Ooh, I'm definitely going to dance because I'm a dancer.
I think I'm going to sing.
Let me hear you low.
No.
Oh.
I'm not going to sing off top of my head.
She's lying.
It's that forced to sing along. It's a sing-along, so I have to sing along.
So somebody play a song and then you just start singing.
Let me get my phone. Let's see if she's going to do it. We're going to force you to sing.
We're going to force you to sing.
You're not
going to
force me to sing because I probably don't even know the song. You
just said. Look,
let's see what you got.
If I know the song, I don't know that song. I need ratchet music. You don't listen to the music I listen to.
Look. What's that?
See?
Put something that we know.
Start
playing music and then you
come on. What you want to hear?
I don't know. What's my phone?
You know what? Okay, let's see what she got. We're gonna force her to do this talent. Let's
Why?
Look, I'm not you gonna can't be sing. Rapping. You gotta actually
no,
sing.
No, I was gonna rap.
You said sing along. You didn't say rap along. She didn't say
rap and singing is the same thing.
No. Rap what? Poetry, no. Singing is singing. Singing can be poetry, but it's singing.
No.
We're not doing spoken word, Kandice.
Why would you
come
but
on,
that's what I do, though. shout. So then you gotta dance to every song you hear.
Okay, you sing it and I dance to it. We're doing a challenge right now, y'all.
I don't want to.
Here we go.
I don't know. See, I only got rap songs on here.
Okay, well, go ahead and do one. Just hit one. First one.
No.
She acting weird.
I'm not acting weird. I don't want to do it.
Is it the hookah?
It might be the hookah. But we can't play the song.
Oh, I got that song.
We don't have that many listeners. Go ahead.
And then we get sued.
I like that song.
This one?
I take the song out. I just keep the sing along in. I try to fade it out.
You see how they try and get me out here in these streets?
Okay. Oh.
I'm not gonna sing.
Oh, okay. Well, let's go to the next question. My God. Go to the next question. Go ahead, shoot the question.
Yeah, you gotta scroll through.
Oh, we all got true love already, so we're gonna skip. Oh wait, no, hold on.
Bring it back. Go ahead. What is that?
Oh, shoot. Would you rather have another 10 years with your partner or one night stand with your celebrity crush?
That's a good one.
First of all, who's your celebrity crush?
So
that's a good one.
So Lil Wayne used to be when
I was in love with Lil Wayne. You couldn't tell me nothing. Him and Bow Wow. Yep. And when Bow Wow made the video with Ciara and they kissed in the elevator, girl, I was in the living room crying like, how could he do this to me? Lil Wayne was cute.
That was my sister-in-law.
I love Lil Wayne back in the day, but right now.
He looked like a ninja turtle. He does.
But John Legend can get it. Okay? John Legend. All he got to do is sing to me. I'm just going to drop my drawers. Because I love me. John. And like Jennings, you know.
What?
He gave me that gangster jail cell type, but still got money a little bit. I'll be robbing these.
Wait, hold on. Let's think about the question, though.
Okay, what the question was?
Because you're getting caught up
with that. But I definitely want to do 10 more years with my husband. Yes.
Yeah, I would too. Okay.
Crush is like a one-night stand. He ain't gonna be able to bring me everything my husband brings. So
absolutely not. And it's one night.
And I'm just gonna be like, just a night. You know,
and then it might not even be great.
And I may not even be. It may not be great. Right. And I may
and
not even get the man.
I know, right? And you're wasting your whole
ten years for that one night. So yeah, you're definitely choosing your husband.
Oh, my husband for
so,
sure.
But who is your husband?
Okay, so look, this is so
here we go.
Not my type. Neither one of them, because I don't like little men. I don't like skinny men, and I don't like. You know, my husband's kind of fair skinned. I'm not a light skinned.
So who you about to say, The Rock?
No, I was gonna say no, but see, these men are skinny. And not big. I love T.I. Except I don't like what's going on with his hair right now.
Okay.
I love T.I. Yes. And Andre 3000.
Oh, I love Andre 3. Andre 3.
And when I found out he was singing to some lady in the airport, my heart was broken.
What do you mean?
I'm like, that could have been me. Like a couple years back, you didn't hear that he was playing the guitar and singing to some lady in the airport?
Oh, my God.
Where was I at? That could have been me.
Oh,
but yes,
I love him. He's at work too, and I love his
role. And I love him. I love him. I love his personality. Like,
laid back. So you chilled with him before you said you love his personality.
I've never chilled with him. In my mind.
I love his personality. I like the way he walks, the way he holds my hand. That's how far you went. Okay, well, we definitely all doing it 10 years.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so we have 3 more questions. Let's see. Well, it's 3 of us, so we're going to ask 6 questions. So we have 3 more questions. I did right. Would you rather? I don't have no sexual ones on here.
You always talking about sex, bro. I mean, brother, when you come home, when we leave, I need y'all to just Do I have to be here to start y'all off? Do I need to go get you a bottle or something?
Shut up.
She got a bottle right there.
No, would you rather?
She needs something stronger.
I'm trying to drink this slowly.
Would you rather? It's some more. Would you rather? I already know that one, so I'm not going to ask. Would you rather buy 10 things you don't need every time you go shopping or always forget the one thing you need when you go to the store?
Oh, my God. That's
that
happened, the worst.
All that happens to me all the time.
I know. Every time I go to Target.
Oh, my God.
This is my work alarm. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God. You was off today. You still got it on?
Because it's your phone. Well, look, it is off, but the alarm still goes off. See, it's off.
My goodness.
You know how many times I went to Walmart today?
That's a shame.
I went before work.
What's that work? What do you mean?
What you mean? I went before work. And when I got off, I went to Walmart again.
So what did you forget?
So I forgot to make Cameron spaghetti yesterday because we had something else for dinner. And he was like, Mom, where's my spaghetti? I said, oh, shoot. So I couldn't.
Go to Walmart again this evening.
For what?
Are you off tomorrow?
No.
You are back to work. You told me you were gonna make Rasta pasta.
I want the Rasta pasta too, man.
No, you don't want it because it's too spicy. You want shrimp. Talia can't have shrimp. Yeah, I just got a lot going on.
Did I show you that veggie meat? It's so good.
No.
They have like the sausage. Okay, I'm sorry.
She said it's
way off the top.
But you know what?
She don't eat meat, y'all. So
the thing that she brought me the other day.
What was it?
I don't know what you got. I was gonna say hi.
What you get?
This is Southwest breakfast wrap or something like that from Tropical Smoothie. It's really good.
Oh my God. No, I haven't had it. I don't have time to go to Tropicals.
I didn't have time. She ordered it. You wasn't at work.
You weren't there.
No. Oh my God.
But I feel like I have to go to Starbucks in the morning.
Yeah.
I got to drive like a maniac to get to work.
Okay, so what's your time?
Is my time or my turn?
Turn. Time, turn, same. Tomato, tomato.
Oh, she's been smoking on that
for a while. I'm sorry. Like,
Jesus, thank you so much. She don't know how to pass it.
Would you rather have a personal maid or a personal chef?
Ooh. It don't say both?
It says or.
Would you rather?
Ooh. I think I would do the chef because I don't mind cleaning. Mm-hmm. I'll clean eventually.
Give me a maid for like 6 months and then I turn it over to a chef.
No. It's either or. You always trying to get both.
Give me a maid.
A maid?
I'm tired of cleaning.
I'm going to take the chef.
Two dogs, a man.
I'd rather come home and clean on Sunday and then have a chef that cooks every night.
Well, I go out a lot, so
yeah.
It wouldn't be good for me.
Oh, yeah. Shoot.
This is the last question. Make it a good one.
Make it good.
This is a good hookah, y'all.
It is.
Y'all should definitely try this flavor.
We gotta get Mighty Freeze.
Strawberry and orange.
You can't just do Mighty Freeze the whole time and then just stop.
I know, they didn't have any. What do you want me to do? Make it?
Maybe we should try making it.
We should do that.
We should. We gotta look it up to see how to make it.
Oh, this is for me. I don't see any good ones.
How you say this is nasty?
Okay, that one right there. I like the nasty.
I don't like that. No, it's not that kind of nasty. This is gross. Would you rather wear the same socks for a month or the same underwear for a week?
Ooh.
I think I'll do the socks.
I'll do the socks because my feet don't sweat.
I know mine don't either.
I'm not doing the socks.
Still.
No, but
you
don't.
I'm not doing them drawers. So you got to turn them over. Can you wash them?
No,
I'm always trying to get out of it.
All the time.
I'm gonna do them socks. Okay,
I'm gonna do the socks too because you can take your socks off and you can spray your socks with some Febreze.
You can spray them drawers too.
Oh,
you know what I mean? You can wear the same drawers.
Then you be like,
do y'all not know how to make? How many people wear the same drawers?
They do. You know what I was thinking about?
Who do you hang with?
Homeless women do when they get their cycle.
Oh shoot. Oh.
Like how does that work? I always
tissue. Tissues on nothing but a dollar.
I mean they have cash.
I said homeless people. Homeless people have cash app.
They have cash app. You haven't been downtown where they got the board cash app me?
No. Well, how do they get a phone?
They got the
free phone.
How they charge their phone? They homeless.
They have
shelters. They make ways.
I don't know.
They can go into
McDonald's. Well, I was thinking about back in the day.
Yeah.
back in the day, I mean, they it's had
because I was younger when I was thinking about that because my aunt was homeless and I was like, I wonder what she do when she was
they have shelters where people can go like during the day, like to just kind of hang out. And they have like supplies and stuff. And what do they call the place where they give away food and food banks where they give away that kind of stuff? So,
I mean, they're a resource.
Well, nowadays, yeah, but I'm thinking about back in the days when I was younger.
The sad thing is, that is gross. The economy, like homeless people, I mean, some homeless people, they still have jobs. Like, there's people.
We are their job.
Well, yeah, that's true.
When you get them a dollar, that adds up.
Look, let me tell you, I was like, I will never give anybody money ever again.
I still do.
No, I had somebody, I like got off the expressway and I was sitting at the light and this guy felt so bad. He was like standing at the end of the expressway begging for money. Mm-hmm. I gave him like, and y'all know I don't keep cash on me. I had a $20 bill. I was like, oh, yeah, you know, this is, I gave him the whole 20 because I didn't, and I felt bad. Yeah, because I never have cash on me. And I was like, oh, this was meant to be. So, you know, as I'm getting ready to pull off, he was like, oh, thank you so much because I spent my last 20 on beer and I was so lucky.
He knew
I was
going to
give you.
Oh, my God.
I was so mad.
God said, I'm going to bring it back around. He knew exactly what to do. They got to re-up on their stuff, too. Just like you like to eat snacks and all of that. They got to re-up on their stuff.
Right. My mom taught me to always look at their sneakers. If their sneakers don't look like they homeless, then they're homeless.
Well, so I've gotten to the point where it's like I go by how I feel because I was like, I was so mad in that moment. I was like, I will never end. You homeless people and blah, 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 blah. And then I was like, no, you know, just based on how I feel. It's like, because I feel like sometimes you just have a feeling. And if you feel moved to give it to somebody, then, you know, give it to them.
I got
to
get that move in then because I had a situation like that. It was a homeless guy. He had his baby in a stroller.
Oh, and, I hate when they use kids and dogs.
He was like, you know, me and my daughter, me, they always use
kids. They always have their kids.
And it was like, my home, we need a place to stay or whatever. And I went out of my way just to make sure. He said, all I need is $15, you know. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, okay, let's go up there and, you know, meet you there. Put it on your book, whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. You don't got to go with me. I said, look, I prayed about it. Look, whatever it is. If this is what God told me to do, I'm going to go ahead and do it. Mm-hmm. After that, I see him the next day. The same spot. Me and my child, we out. I said, bro, you just asked me for money yesterday. Ever since then, I feel the same way you feel. Like, I can't. But I do give out, like, little bags sometimes. Yeah. I try to keep them in my car.
That's good.
Yeah. A little care bag or whatever. Even though one person cursed me out, I don't want no care bag. Oh, he said, I need $5. I was like, woo, give me my bag back, okay?
I think because I'm from New York.
You used to.
I'm used to seeing homeless people, so yeah. I just like, yeah, no.
So when the last time you got to a homeless person, Candice?
I never get to a homeless person.
You need to do better.
I think that's my New York mentality. I just see them all the time. And I know it's stuff out there. Yeah. I think that's what it is. And then down here, I don't really see homeless people because I'm in my car.
Well,
and
I don't go downtown. I don't either. But I feel like the way the economy is going right now, it's like we got a bunch of people that is close to being homeless.
That's
so,
right. That's true. I don't know. That's my New York mentality. I'm sorry, y'all.
Well, it is time to shake this shit up. Let's shake it up. We're going to let Amira shake it up.
Yeah, shake it up, and then you can pick.
Ooh.
You want some more?
Shake it up. Okay.
What we got?
Oh, wait.
No, I got two.
In one.
It's a long one.
I like the long ones. It may be about love. I don't know.
Well, you should have looked at them because I sent them all to you.
What values you get out of a friendship and or a relationship? What is a core value of a friendship?
I feel like they all about friendships. Let me see. Can you ask the question again?
I think she meant what values do you get out of a friendship and or a relationship, and what are the core values of a friendship?
You want to start?
I mean, I think everybody has different core values or what they, what a friendship means to them. For me, like trust, honesty, loyalty are some of the core values. Like me and my best friend, I call her my sister. Her name is Carlita. Mm-hmm. She lives in Pensacola.
Hey, Carlita.
She's the one that I be showing my god baby. They call me Gigi. He's so cute. Oh my god, I love that baby. But her and I have been friends since like 10th grade in high school. Mm. Y'all know I'm old, so that's a long time. So she is more like my sister.
She is not that old.
Right. I know I'm not that
old. You make it seem like
I'm
60.
So look, 60. Almost. Her and I, like, I'm closer with her than I am with my own sister.
Yeah, I'll be like
she
that.
Is like, that's my girl. And we've been through ups and downs and thick and thin. And it's like her and I mean, y'all know I'm like busy all the time. And I have to do better with not neglecting my friendships and
yes.
my relationships.
Yes.
And she's one of those people, and we've done it like several times where it's like she gets busy with work and family and life. And it's like we'll go like 5 months without talking. And then it's like we'll pick up like.
Like
no time has passed.
But that's true friendship.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That's true friendship.
I call her my Pookie. Mm-hmm. She just got her master's and now she
teaches. Congratulations.
Yes, she teaches at a university, so I call her Pookie, Professor Pookie.
Let's go.
Yeah, so that's like that she is the epitome of.
But when y'all go through those ups and downs, it's like, how do you get back? How you get back from the downs?
So we've never, okay, so when I say, let me rephrase, because when I say ups and downs, it's like we have been through like our personal, like with the loss of my mom, the loss of her dad, you know, things with her children, because all our children are kind of the same age, so things that we go through with our kids, just like those kind of struggles, it's like we're always, like we've been through life together.
Okay, okay.
And we've grown up together because we've known each other, you know.
For years.
Forever. And
yeah.
So it's never been where her and I have had like a major falling out
okay.
or anything like that. We did have kind of a disagreement where I felt like, and looking back on it now, it was like, oh, it's so petty. I felt like she had a conversation with somebody that I was dating. And I was like, you shouldn't have that conversation with him. It was up to me to share when I felt comfortable with sharing.
Right, right.
And so she shared something with him. And I'm like, why would you do that?
Why would you?
Like, oh,
yeah.
We're just talking. And so
and that should
back
have
then,
right.
You know, I was a bit of a grudge holder.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was like, I'm mad. I'm not going to talk to her no more.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she betrayed me.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like she was disloyal, you
mm-hmm.
know, this, that, and the other. So her and I probably went for probably about a year without talking. And then
that's a
it was.
Mm-hmm.
And so she got me because her kids are my god kids and
mm-hmm.
vice versa. And so she sent her two oldest kids to my house with a letter.
I'm about to start crying.
I miss you. Yes, I'm about to start crying. I'm emotional. It was just like, you know, I'm sorry, and you know, this is going on, and that's going on, and we really need to sit down and talk and reconnect. And that was like the only issue. Over.
I'm sorry to make you get there, but
I know, it's not even a big deal. It's just
you know?
Because I love her to death, and
yeah.
like I could not imagine. And it's so crazy because my birthday is November 7th. Her birthday is November 1st, and we say we're sisters from another mister because we are so much alike.
Mm-hmm.
And it's crazy, right? Exactly. And so, like, it's so funny because I'll be going through certain things in my life, and she'll be going through the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, how in the heck does that happen? But it's like we've just always been there for each other, and that's my
and the friendship
thing.
Just been
and
like
yeah.
up and up and up. And it take a real friend to like, you know, I'm trying to get emotional from that, but it take a real friend.
It's so
emotional.
Oh,
like, it may be the wine. It take a real friend to like know what they did wrong at, and
mm-hmm.
say, you know what, let's get this thing back on track.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you can really think about like. If I lose you, like Candace, if I lose you, like Millie, if I lose Millie.
You're going to lose your mind. Because you
bro.
Lost your mind. And I was only, how long I was off? Like 5 days?
That's what
Wait,
I'm saying.
What?
Like,
when I ain't come to, when I don't come to work.
I don't call her. I try my best not to call her.
She
so,
lose her mind.
I mean, like, that's kind of, I think that's good. Because you probably don't call her because you want her to.
Be off.
Yeah.
You know,
relax.
Be off. Relax.
But I don't really
like,
be
no
doing
problem.
Anything.
But like, if I lose like my best friends. Like, if I lose my people, those friendships, like, okay, like, I see Candace all the time.
Mm-hmm.
But me and Millie, it's just like how you and your friends, you know. And we don't talk every day. Like, I'm her son, godmom, mm-hmm. you know, I'm there for him. I don't see him because I don't see her.
Right.
But she know, if you leave this earth, baby, that child is my child. You
right.
know, and
right.
Jordan gonna know, awesome. Like, he's here, but he ain't gonna be here by himself.
Right.
You know, I'm thinking about doing like a trust fund for her child. Like, that's mm-hmm. how deep it is. Like, Jax is my child, you
right.
know. And if I lose her, I don't know, because
yeah.
she's there for me no matter what. And we never got an argument. We always had, like, one little thing when she stopped working with me. And I was like, you got to do better. Like, you said you're my best friend. You need to do better. And ever since that conversation, it was like, you know what? I do need to do better. And she hasn't been, it don't matter if she's sick. She going to make sure if I call her, hey, what do you need? How can I help you make it to all my birthday trips? And vice versa.
And that's not even friendship. That's like
sisterhood.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, and the same thing with you, Ken.
No,
it's like when
blood
I was
is
down.
Than water. It's
yes.
Like,
it's
not.
But it's not. Mm-hmm. It's not. Because water is so much, like my little sister, that's my blood. But I know she's going to always be there no matter the ups and the downs. That comes with family.
Right.
But with, like, I can always go back to, like, I've been knowing Candace for over 8 years, and it's like, we connected when we first met. We connected. Like,
right.
a year in between that, we connected.
Mm-hmm.
But when I was going through my whole spasm of wanting to take my own life, and, you know, we're going to talk about that in another podcast, but she was there for me. Like, she went out, she gave me a hug, like, hey, this, you're not going to do this. You're not, like, I got your back. And when she said the words, I got your back, like,
mm-hmm. She's so emotional. I can't.
She really had me. You know, she called me. She checked up on me. She made sure I was okay. You know, I'm sorry.
Oh, Pooh, I love you. It's okay.
But she really made sure, like, you had certain people that called. Like, you called. Millie called. You know, my second mom called. My older sister called. But it was, like, certain people that you expect to call that didn't call.
That you didn't hear from. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's like, if you can, my whole thing, what I was trying to make a point of, if you can think about if this person leaves this earth and how you will feel
right.
if they leave this earth,
right.
it's everything that you've been through with that person is worth it.
Right.
You know, even the people that you really hate, like one of my friends I had to let go recently, if she leaves this earth, I would still feel away because my love for her was genuine.
Right.
I still love her.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, I understand why she can't be in my life. And that was like one of my best friends too.
Right.
But if she left this earth,
you're still going to be affected.
I'm going to be affected because
right.
of the love. But
yeah.
I'm trying to figure out, could you go back again?
Yeah.
You know,
right.
could you go back again for the fourth time?
Right.
Could you go back? And
right.
I'm at a point where it's like, I don't make so much growth with myself, I can't see myself go back.
Yeah.
Right.
Even though I love this person, I just can't see myself go back.
Yeah, because sometimes things happen for a reason.
Right.
And, you know, you just have to know when to kind of separate yourself from people.
The separation is hard.
And it is. It's like breaking up in a relationship.
Yeah.
So I definitely get it, but I will say that for you to share that, I appreciate you sharing that. Because there's a lot of people, and to share that, like, publicly. Because there's a lot of people that go through things like that to the point where it's, like, you know, depression, and they feel like, you know, I don't want to be here anymore. And there's a lot of people out there that feel the exact same way.
Yeah.
And they don't realize, people always think that they're alone.
Yeah,
they don't think that
right.
there's other people out there that are experiencing what they're experiencing or
yeah.
going through what they're going through. And I think it's so important for people to understand that, you know, you're not alone.
Yeah.
And we don't know how this might
affect
somebody's life, how it might resonate with somebody else. And so I think it's important that, you know, we're always taught, like, I know, like, my generation, it's like we were taught, like, what goes on at home
stays
at
home.
You don't talk
we'll go
about,
to church and
you don't
pray
talk
about it.
Yeah, you don't talk about what goes on as family business
yeah.
and this, that, and the other. But I think certain things need to be talked about.
Yeah.
Certain things need to be shared because there are people out there that don't have anybody.
Yeah.
And their only source, as much as I dislike social media sometimes, it's like there's a lot to be gained from social media.
That's
there's
true.
A lot of therapy to be gained from social media.
Mm-hmm.
And
it have its good and it have its bad.
Yeah, when we are comfortable in what we've experienced and what we've gone through, and comfortable to the point where it's like, I can share this with somebody else in the hopes that it might help. I think that's important. Yeah. I think that's commendable.
I mean, it got to a point where you know, we spoke about jumping off the mountain. You know, I'm not trying to let this episode go on too long, but we talked about jumping off the mountain earlier, right, in a jokey way, with our insecurities. But it had got to a point where, you know, I try not to be so open about it, but it had got to a point where I really did want to go to Tennessee, find a mountain, park my truck, jump off the mountain, like, and leave everybody behind. It was, I got that low with that friendship. So that, to value your friendship is everything to me. Like, I don't need my friends to call me every day. I have this one friend, you know, Deanna, and I've been knowing her since I was working in the airport back in 2005. And when I tell you, I call her my sister, and the last time I seen this girl is at my divorce party from my first marriage, and I don't see her. We don't call. You know, I see her on IG. I see her kids that her twins that she just had. But if I need her, she's gonna be there. And I'm telling you, I haven't talked to her in years.
That's another value. I didn't even think about that. But security in a friendship.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's deep.
You want to be secure in your friendship and know that regardless of what you're going through, that person
that you got
be there. And they're, like you said, they're going to have you. They're going to have your back. And time.
Yes. It
does not
matter.
Right, it doesn't.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter how long I go without talking to this person. I know I can pick up the phone. Like Carlita, if I didn't talk to her for like 2 years, I know that I could still pick up the phone and call her and be like, hey, I'm going through this. And I was going through some stuff with my mom before my mom passed, and she lives in Pensacola. And it's like her and her mom jumped in her car just because she knew I was going through it and drove to, just for the weekend, drove to Georgia
that's
to see me
friendship.
And give me a hug. And it's like, those are people, like, we all need people to get that.
That's true friendship. Have you ever been through anything like that? Like, if you had to answer the question?
I mean, I haven't experienced anything like that. And I don't know why. I think that's just me. I have, like, this wall.
Mm-hmm.
And it's hard for you to break through. So once you break through that wall, and you my friend, you my friend, you my best friend, you my sister, I'm gonna be there for you no matter what. But like, the values in a friendship that I value is security, trust, honesty. Just be honest. Like,
don't lie to me.
Right. Oh, I hate
lying. Like, why
would you lie to me?
Some people lie.
Just to lie.
Yeah.
Some people lie just to lie because it sounds good.
You and my friend.
But I'm a see through that lie.
Right.
If I know you the way I know you.
Right. So when I first got married, one of my friends at the time, my best friend at the time, she had a party on the beach. Me and Francois had just got into a car accident. She got mad at me and stopped talking to me because I didn't come to her party. I'm like, what? I was in a whole car accident.
Did she ask you, like, are
no,
you
okay?
No,
we got to a whole argument because she went back and forth with me on Facebook, and I'm just like, okay. So, nope. So, it's very hard for me.
So, from that friendship, it was just like, you know what? You were able still to have other friends because of how we became friends. Yeah, you got other friends.
Right, but it was hard for me to have somebody close like how she was, because she was like my sister. We was sisters, best friends, but ever since her, no. So now,
over time,
I have you, I have Tia,
y'all
right there, and then I got my other friends. I'm all close to all of my friends, so.
You have different groups.
Yeah, I have different groups of people now, but as when I was growing up, that really hurt me, and I was just like, I don't know.
You know, there's some people that you can have, like, I have different groups. I can tell my close people this, and I can tell my other group of people whatever I want to share with them.
Right.
Because some people bring your information back up, and
absolutely.
I'm like friends.
So that's what I was going to say. I wouldn't even consider those friends. Those would be more like acquaintances.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm not going to give you the Gloria, I'm calling you my friend. If I can't trust you and I can't confide in you and I can't trust you with my secrets or my heart or no. It's like, you're not.
But you only learn that when you go through an argument with them and they bring it up.
See, I don't argue.
Some people you can know by the end of the
day. I don't argue because if I argue with you, I'm going to hurt your feelings.
Yeah, we don't need that.
No. I'm going to go from 1,000.
I'm like, just calm down.
So. Speaking of friends, do y'all feel like your husband's like your best friend?
Yes. Because over the weekend, Francois and I, we had a family issue, and I went in. He didn't try to stop me. He just was like,
he was just like,
do what you got to do. And they was like, you need to control your wife. I said, control his wife? And I just went in, and he was just staring at me like, he's like, I'm just gonna let her do whatever. So we was in the elevator and he looked at me and he was like, oh, she mad. I can tell she mad.
Friend, like, look, hey, I need you to go ahead and do what you gotta do, but come back.
Right. He was like, do what you gotta do, but bring it back in. Yeah. We're gonna bring it back in.
But that's what they're supposed to do.
Yeah, I didn't have to say nothing. He just saw it. He was like, it's okay. Calm down. It's all right.
Right. But that's what a best friend as a husband, I feel like, supposed to be like. They don't really have to say too much, but they can just give you that eye contact, you know?
Because he looked at me.
How you be a kid.
Or just touch you. Touch your arm.
And it's like, oh, okay. I'm all right.
So do y'all want to shake it up again? Or, you know how you be doing last episode? You were just like, I'm ready.
Because I didn't feel last. I was tired. I was sick. My head was like, I don't know if it was the alcohol that was, I don't know. I was like, I gotta go. I can't. You want to shake it up again?
Or you
want
to?
You want me to shake it up? I can shake it up.
We can shake it up one time. You know what I guess? We try to shake it up 2 times, you know? Let's see what you got to come now. Shake it up.
We gotta add more questions. I keep saying that, but I never do.
You know, you gotta add more questions because you come up with the questions.
I know.
I always feel like it's two.
Oh my gosh. It's so funny.
You always keep getting
the did you come up with these? Is this you?
This her.
It's me and the internet. mostly from the internet.
She complained. So the one that we pulled, did we put it back in
just,
there?
Just leave it.
We got it.
What message have you received about what you needed to do to receive love?
What message
have you received about what you needed to do to receive love?
See, when I was growing up, the message was, my home is broken. Mm-hmm. So, I didn't really, me and my brother, we just was trying to figure it out because it was just broken. And then my dad wasn't there. And then my aunts and my uncles, they wasn't doing what they were supposed to do. They wasn't
filling in?
No, not even filling in. They was all on drugs.
Oh, okay.
So, the message I got was don't do drugs ever in life. Because I felt like if you do drugs, you're going to lose your family. You're not going to have a friendship. You're not going to have a family.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to have.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the message I got. Don't do drugs. That was the message I got.
Mine was because my mom, my mom was a single parent when my dad left. So when my dad left, it was more so like, don't trust these niggas.
Oh, my God.
Yes. So ever since I dated or got to know someone, it was just like, I don't trust you.
Right.
You know, I want to get to know you, but I don't trust you.
Right.
And like, it's crazy because that happened. It came into my marriage, like this one, because if I don't trust, all I hear my mama saying, don't trust me now.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm like, I ain't trusting nobody. So now you have to strip yourself away and start building that trust back up. Because that's one thing she taught us, like, don't trust nobody, and you need to be independent.
Right.
Like, you need to carry your own.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So, whatever my mom have taught us.
You
know, we may got the same mama.
Tamika's my sister.
So, it's like, that's two things that she have taught us, like, to make sure y'all independent, you know your ropes, like you know how to pay bills, you know how to gain money, like you know how to take care of yourself. So when nobody else ain't taking care of you, you take care of yourself 100% and don't let nobody get into that. Like my mom taught me how to pay bills when I was 12.
That was good.
Yeah.
Absolutely. She write her bills down in the book. And she got sick. And I'm the daughter that she trusts with her cards for some reason. And she called me her little lawyer. You know, they used to call me grandma. So grandma, mm-hmm. little lawyer. So she was like, look, I need for you to pay my bills. And so that's what taught me how to be like who I am today.
Right.
So it was like those were the two things I learned. Like, don't trust no nigga. Make sure your bills is paid. Right. So I ain't trust no nigga and I make sure my bills paid. Right. So that's what I learned. What about you?
I mean, I learned the same thing. I mean, my mom, same thing. She was like a single mom of four kids and her favorite thing.
Man, we do got to say that.
So my mom's favorite saying was, never let your left hand know what your right hand is doing.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And so it caused a rift in my marriage. Not even a rift, but
a little
for
shame.
Me, I'm a very private person because of how I was raised.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the things that my mom instilled in me. And she said the same thing. It's like, because she worked so hard
mm-hmm.
and she struggled, mm-hmm. I've always been... like, I gotta go, I gotta work, I gotta go hard, I gotta make
yes.
sure, like, security is very important to
yes.
me. Financial security is
financial,
very important
about
to me,
it.
And so mm-hmm. I will go hard, like, in my job, because I gotta make sure that my family has. And so, when me and my husband got together, my husband is a very, I can't even explain it, he's a Libra, he's a very communicative.
My mom is a Libra!
Really?
Yes!
So he's very communicative, he's a man, but he's very... like, he wants to know everything.
In your business.
And he will dig. Like, my husband researches.
He's a digger.
He is. He, I mean, my husband is, like, 49 years old, but he still, like, studies. He still researches. Him and I get in fights because I'm like, dude, when I come home at nighttime, I want, and I'm getting into bed, I don't want clutter. I don't want to see your notepad. I don't want to see your...
That's me on the bed, though. I have all that on the bed.
I don't want to see that. Like, you have a whole office downstairs in the basement. Please take your books. Like, we had a whole room for his books. He orders books, like, every day. And so with me, he's like, I want to know what makes you tick. I want to know what makes you work. I want to know, like... your life from the time,
Virgo?
Like, he's a Libra. He wants to know, like, my life from the time I came out the womb until the time him and I. And I'm like, dude, like, I literally don't think about some of this stuff until it comes up.
Right.
Like, seriously.
Right.
And so for him, he felt like I was intentionally keeping things from him.
Oh,
because, and some of the stuff I was,
Virgo stuff,
because
man.
I don't know, possibly. But some of it I was, because, like, in the beginning of our relationship, because I was like, I don't trust you.
Right.
I don't feel like, because of the way I was raised, I never let my right hand know what my left hand is doing, or my left hand know what my right hand is doing.
Mm-hmm.
So certain things I didn't share with him because I hadn't gotten to the point where I felt comfortable prior to him and I getting married. And he was like, no, this is a partnership. This is, when we got married, this is a marriage. You should be able to feel comfortable telling me any and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I just didn't, because of my upbringing, because my dad wasn't there, I didn't feel comfortable that he was going to always be there.
Mm-hmm.
And so now... I don't know how many years into our marriage, just like I'm comfortable that he's always going to be there. It's not a fear. So it took me a while to get there.
You don't
though.
Think that come off like a sense of control?
With him? No. With him, no.
No.
Not at
that's
all.
Just his personality.
It's just his personality. He's like that.
Okay.
And the funny thing is my daughter's a Libra too.
Wow.
And him and her used to bump heads. And I'm like, y'all bump heads because y'all are exactly the same.
Mm-hmm.
They're very creative. And I told you, I think me and you had that conversation.
Mm-hmm.
They're very creative. They're very artistic. They're very intelligent.
Mm-hmm.
They are very... they're deep thinkers.
Mm.
They are over analytical. They analyze everything. I'm more controlling than he is.
I can
kind
of see that.
What?
Maybe you're nosy.
I am very nosy.
Yeah.
I think
that's so nosy
deals.
People are very controlling.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
I'm nosy too. I'm a Cancer.
That's Scorpio tendency.
I got it. Maybe my moon.
Your moon or your rising? You should do your birth chart.
Okay, I should do that. I'm gonna check that
we
out.
We didn't do it?
No, you did yours.
I did mine. Audit tears.
I don't know what happened to ours. Me and my husband did ours like a long time ago. We even did it with the kids because he feels like, you know, when you study that, again, him studying it. He's like, especially like with the kids, he's like, you know, if you learn this stuff about you now, and a lot of stuff we've read, it's like, dang, that's
me.
True. Yeah,
right.
It is. And
mm-hmm.
like, even with the kids, and he's like, man, it'll kind of step the kids up if they know this stuff and they understand and they, it'll set them up to be greater.
Right.
Because they kind of understand.
Yeah, I do. You know what? We all should, since you don't know yours anymore, the moon and the rise, we all should do that in
Why?
This spirit. I know you know yours, but you can do it with Cameron.
Yeah, I'm going to do Cameron. I did Francois. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do Cameron.
Yeah. Well, All right, you guys. We definitely had a great episode with Amira.
Thanks for coming.
So happy that you came.
I'm so excited. This was
to talk
fun.
About
this
our insecurities. You know, but it's about that time. Kat is definitely ready to go home. Y'all know she's always ready to go home. And thank you for coming.
Thanks for coming.
We have Shake This Shit Up. This is Hookahs and Conversations. My name is Tamika.
It's your girl Kandice.
And we have Amira. All right, we out.
Bye, guys.
Drop that beat.
Make sure you follow us up on our IG page, up on the Hookahs and Conversation. Also, tune in up on our YouTube page, up on the Hookahs and Conversation. And
send us questions to hookahsandconversations@gmail.com so we can put it in a bowl and shake this shit up. And
this your girl Tamika.
This your girl Kandice.
We out. Drop that beat.
Shake it up. And shake it up.
Shake this shit
up. And shake it up. Shake it up.
Shake this shit up.